Leadership, however, from our point of view, was something that Clive Woodward, the England coach, was really serious about, making sure that we made really good decisions. Teacup, thinking correctly under pressure, this was a term that he would use. After a game, we'd always have an analysis of our decision-making during the game. And we'd sit down and have the key players. You'd have the number nines, you'd have the number tens, you'd have the captain and the vice-captain, and then probably another, probably a bats captain, who probably Johnny Wilkinson. So you'd come and you'd come together after each game and you'd review each decision over a cup of tea. And what we started doing after matches is we started realising that in the moment of us coming together, in that moment of us making a decision on the pitch, we didn't always make the right decision because we didn't get the feeling for the feel of the game. We didn't, you know, think of the whole context of the game. When we played against, sometimes against the Irish, it would pour down with rain and our game plan would go out the window, yet we'd stick to that game plan. So Clive Woodward wanted us to learn from our mistakes and start thinking correctly under pressure. So Clive Woodward came involved and he said we had a separate management company to come in and help us start thinking about innovation, about the way the game is played. And this is the first, this is a statement that was put before the England team in 1996 by the management consultancy, and they asked us to read the statement, and then they said, right, you've got 30 seconds to count the F's. This is the original shirts that we wore in 1995 under different leadership. So this is a really heavy shirt, a bit of blood and sweat on there, so it's not washed, signed by the team. But you can see there's big collars, these big collars, and it's cotton traders, and it's really, really heavy. So whenever it would rain, this would take up all the rain. So instead of it being, you know, being 2 or 3 kilograms, it'd be 5 or 6 kilograms, which makes a difference if you're carrying that round. And obviously as well, when you put it on, it's not very, you know, hugging. That would be tucked into your shorts. So you're carrying all of this extra weight. I'll just pass it round if you want to get have a feel of that. It changed. It did change into this, which is, this is much more lightweight. The biggest, toughest one was getting over. This is the forwards one. This is the one that Martin Johnson would wear. No collar, okay? There's a catching patch here. So for Martin Johnson being a second row, his job was to catch the ball. So this was a catching pad for him. And obviously he was doing scrummaging and wanted to be as tight as possible. So they put some scrummaging sort of pads at the top so they could use that. So when you have a look at that, you'll feel the weight of it is completely different. I've got this has never been this has never been used. I can only think who could try this on, but I thought of Tom. What do you reckon? Tom, do you want to try this on for me? Right. So, over your trousers. So basically, I want to come up here and I'll show you. Right. Right. So No. Do you want to try it on?
Not really.
No. Okay. Right. So
I know many people at that.
This was the basically what we would wear. You're going to try the top on at least. Right. So this is the top.
Is that they wear.
It's an English top. So get your phones out. This is my top.
Is it?
This is my top. Yeah.
Is it one of these tight things?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, you're joking. You make it
on. Oh my God, he's going to get into it. Have we got a medic? Right, so. Yeah. There we go. Right. So. He looks all right, though, doesn't he?
Just taking a picture there.
Hey.
I'm sweating.
There's not many Scottish people who would try on a jersey. That's pretty impressive. Ice skating was, for me, a new challenge, and a lot of people ask me, you know, why I did well in the TV show. I think one of the things is that when you're a rugby player, you're not scared to injure yourself, so that was the first hurdle. But the second hurdle of trying to skate, the first thing what they do is they approach you and ask you, do you want to do the ice skating? I didn't know much about it. And then they take you for a trial on the ice. You had to go for a trial with Torvald and Dean. Now, I turned up and I just fell all over the place. I was literally all over the place. And they thought it would be funny because I was that bad, being this sportsman. And I'd just retired from rugby. But what they forgot is that sportsmen, and the reason why I think sportsmen do quite well in these reality TV shows is because someone gives them a problem and they've got to try something that they can't do, it's outside their comfort zone, and what do? They work out the best way to do it. And they're used to working under pressure. So I found in the Dancing on Ice, the only reason why I won it in 2007 is because a lot of the people around me, you know, weren't good in that situation where they had to perform under pressure.